the wrath of God, when does it come? Well, Joel 2:31 says, the sun shall be turned to darkness and the moon into blood before the great and terrible day of the Lord come. Remember the darkness that it talked about? The sun shall be turned to darkness and the moon. Has that happened yet? No. That will happen before the day of the Lord come. Y'all, that's pretty clear, isn't it? That will happen before the day of the Lord come. Now, turn over to Revelation chapter 6. Pretty much everybody agrees Revelation 6 is talking about tribulation. All right, and I wholeheartedly agree. And when we get to the sixth seal in Revelation, it says, and I beheld, and when he had opened the sixth seal, lo, there was a great earthquake, and the sun became black as sackcloth of hair. That sounds like it's being darkened, isn't it? And the moon became as blood, and the stars of heaven fell unto the earth, even as a fig tree casteth her untimely figs when she is shaken of a mighty wind. And the heaven departed as a scroll when it is rolled together, and every mountain and island moved out of their places. And the kings of the earth and the great men, remember the mighty men? Remember the rich men? The kings of the earth, the great men and the rich men and the chief captains and the mighty men and every bondman and every freeman hid themselves in the dens of the rocks of the mountains and said to the mountains and rocks, fall on us and hide us from the face of him that sitteth on the throne and from the wrath of the Lamb, for the great day of his wrath is come, and who shall be able to stand? Y'all see that? Just like it taught in the Old Testament, just like it taught in Zechariah, we see the day of the Lord come, and God, the sun's dark, moon turned to blood. God pours out his wrath. The mighty men, the rich men. Why did it mention those things back in the Old Testament? Why did it mention it here in Revelation? It's showing those details because it's the same event. God does not pour his wrath out until after we're out of here and until after the sun has been darkened and the moon has turned to blood. He doesn't do it until the sun being darkened and moon turned to blood. When does that happen? After the tribulation. Well, how do you know that? Well, turn over to Matthew chapter 24. We don't have time to do this tonight, but if you go in Matthew 24 and Revelation 6, you can line up the events, the order of events, perfectly. It is very, Matthew 24 is talking about the tribulation, and it very clearly lines up with what we see in Revelation chapter 6. And look what it says in verse 29, immediately after the tribulation of those days, the sun shall be darkened, and the moon shall not give her light. And the stars shall fall from heaven, and the powers of the heaven shall be shaken. That's a pretty notable event, isn't it? The Bible calls it that great and notable day of the Lord. And right there we see the sun being darkened and moon turned to blood. And when does that happen? It happens after the tribulation. After the tribulation, after the sun is darkened and the moon is turned to blood, okay? Then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven, and then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn, and they shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. Notice all the tribes of the earth mourning. Remember Revelation 6, all the mighty men and the rich men crying out. And he shall send his angels with the great sound of the trumpet. And they shall gather together his elect from the four winds, from one end of heaven to the other. Right there. Angels gathering the elect. That is called the rapture. That is called the catching away. That is when we go out. When do we go out? After the tribulation. After the sun is darkened and the moon is turned to blood. Before God pours his wrath out on this world. Do you see the consistency there? I mean, it doesn't really get any clearer than that. But just in case you're still wondering, let me show you a few more examples. Revelation chapter 14, verse 9. It says, and the third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, if any man worship the beast in his image and receive his mark in his forehead or in his hand, the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of God, which is poured out without mixture into the cup of his indignation, and he shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels and in the presence of the Lamb, and the smoke of their torment ascendeth up forever and ever, and they shall have no rest day or night, who worship the beast in his image, and whosoever receiveth the mark of his name. Everybody agrees that the mark of the beast situation, the Antichrist and all that, happens during the tribulation. And notice the Bible says, whoever takes the mark of the beast, they will experience the wrath of God. So that means when people are taking the mark of the beast, the wrath of God has not happened yet. Y'all see that? That's pretty clear, isn't it? The people who take the mark, the Bible promises, they will experience the wrath of God. So therefore, the mark of the beast has to take place before the rapture, before the wrath of God, because immediately after we're taken out is when the wrath of God comes. And the Bible promises those who take the mark will experience the wrath of God. So it hasn't happened yet.